This is Apollo Control at 132 hours, 15 minutes. We have some preliminary figures on the trans-Earth injection maneuver, scheduled to occur about 3 hours, 8 minutes from now. The time of ignition is 135 hours, 23 minutes, 41 seconds.
Here we can read up, over.
You pleased to have it.
Right, Neil. Starting off, congratulatory messages on the Apollo 11 mission have been pouring into the White House from world leaders in a steady stream all day. Among the latest are telegrams from Prime Minister Harold Wilson of Great Britain and the King of Belgium. The world's press has been dominated by news of Apollo 11. Some newsmen estimate that more than 60% of the news used in papers across the country today concern your mission. The New York Times, which we mentioned before, has had such a demand for its edition of the paper today, even though it ran 950,000 copies, that it will reprint the whole thing on Thursday as a souvenir edition. And Premier Alexei Kosygin has sent congratulations to you and President Nixon through former Vice President Humphrey, who is visiting Russia. The cosmonauts have also issued a statement of congratulations. Humphrey quoted Kosygin as saying, "I want you to tell the President and the American people that the Soviet Union desires to work with the United States in the cause of peace." And Mrs. Robert Goddard said today that her husband would have been so happy. He wouldn't have shouted or anything. He would just have glowed. She added, that was his dream, sending a rocket to the moon. People around the world have had many reasons to be happy about the Apollo 11 mission. The Italian police reported that Sunday night was the most crime-free night of the year. And in London, a boy who had the faith to bet $5 with a bookie that a man would reach the moon before 1970 collected $24,000. Pretty good odds. You're probably interested in the comments your wives have made. Neil Jan said about yesterday's activities, "The evening was unbelievably perfect. It is an honor and a privilege to share with my husband, the crew, the manned spacecraft center, the American public, and all mankind, the magnificent experience of the beginning of lunar exploration." She was then asked if she considered the moon landing the greatest moment in her life. She said, "No, that was the day we were married." And Mike Batt said simply, "It was fantastically marvelous." Buzz Jones said, apparently couldn't quite believe the EVA on the moon. She said, "It was hard to think it was real until the men actually moved. After the moon touchdown, I wept because I was so happy." But she added, "The best part of the mission will be the splashdown." In other news, and there was a little bit, another explorer, Thor Heyerdahl, had to give up his attempt to sail a papyrus boat across the Atlantic. The storm-damaged boat was abandoned about 650 miles from Bermuda. The speed of the craft had been reduced to about 25 miles a day, and Heyerdahl said the object of the voyage had not been to provide an endurance test for the crew. Looking at the world of sports, let's see here. While you were busy the other day, Joe Namath and Football Commissioner Pete Rozelle made the announcement that Broadway Joe had agreed to sell his interest in the Bachelor's 3 restaurant and report to the New York Jets. And Joe arrived at the Jets training camp today and had his first workout. And several other Jet players who had held out along with Joe also reported. And Davey Hill from Jackson, Michigan, won his third major golf in his many starts in the past week. He won the Philadelphia Classic. Hill has won 4 tournaments so far this year and is the leading money winner with a cool 129 thou. And in baseball, the West Division of the National League remains a tight race. L.A. and San Francisco are one game behind league-leading Atlanta. And the Astros have a record of 48 wins and 48 losses and are now in 5th place. 7 games out. A twin bill between the Astros and Cincinnati last night were postponed because of rain. The Chicago Cubs are still in first place in the East Division. They led the New York Mets by 4.5 games. And in the American League, Baltimore is breezing toward the Eastern Division title. They lead second place Boston by 11 games. Looking ahead, the All-Star baseball game is scheduled for tomorrow, and President Nixon was scheduled to see the game and then leave immediately after the game for the Pacific splashdown area before going on his tour of Europe. And that about covers the news this day. You guys have been making most of it, and I'm sure we couldn't fill you in on any of the details that you don't already know. Out. Houston, we got a preliminary TEI 30 pad if you're ready to copy.
Ready to copy.
Rod, coming at you. TEI 30. SPS GNN 366901 minus 061 plus 067 135234149er 981 plus 32020 plus 06713 minus 02773 181054013 944 HA is NA plus 00230 32833 228 Delta VC 32625241510355. Next three lines are NA 961 plus 1103 minus 17237 11806 36275 1950452. You set stars or Denob in Vega 242172012. We like 2 jet ullage for 16 seconds. And the horizon will be on the 11-degree mark at TIG minus 2 minutes. And in the other comments, your sextant star is visible after GET of 13450. Ready for your read back, over.
Roger, we have a TEI 30 SPS GNN 36691 minus 061 plus 067 135234149er plus 32020 plus 06713 minus 02773 181054013 NA plus 00230 plus 32833 228 326 25 241510355 NA 3 times plus 1103 minus 17237, 11806, 36275, 19050452, Deneb and Vega, 242172012, 2 jet outlet, 16 seconds. Horizon 11 degree line at take minus 2 minutes, section star visible after 13450, over.
Roger, Mike, good read back, out.
This is Apollo Control at 132 hours, 29 minutes. That last string of numbers read up to the spacecraft included the information the crew will need to start them on their way back to Earth in about 2 hours, 54 minutes. The time of ignition for the trans-Earth injection burn again is 135 hours, 23 minutes, 42 seconds. They will burn their 20,500-pound thrust service propulsion system engine for 2 minutes, 28 seconds, increasing their speed by 3,283 feet per second. And our preliminary estimate is that that will put them into the Pacific Ocean at the primary landing site at 195 hours, 18 minutes, 47 seconds, ground elapsed time. or almost precisely on the flight plan. The spacecraft weight at the time they do the trans-earth injection burn will be 36,691 pounds. We'll continue to stand by for any communication from the spacecraft. We now have about 29 minutes, 30 seconds until the Apollo 11 goes around the corner and behind the moon out of radio contact.
Thank you.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston, 7 minutes to LOS, next AOS 13346, you're looking good, going over the hill, out.
This is Apollo Control. We're now about 30 seconds from loss of signal with Apollo 11 on the 29th revolution. We'll be reacquiring in about 46 minutes as the spacecraft comes around on its 30th revolution. And that will be the next to the last full revolution in lunar orbit. The trans-Earth injection maneuver will be performed at the end of the 30th revolution, just after beginning the 31st revolution of the moon. Apollo 11 is now in an orbit with a high point of 62.6 nautical miles and a low point of 54.2. The current spacecraft velocity is 5,356 feet per second. And we show an orbital weight of 36,691 pounds. We have loss of signal now. We'll be coming back up when we reacquire in about 45 minutes. At 133 hours, this is Apollo Control, Houston.
NCC himself. Jeez.
Did you try the other line?
Well, no, I haven't tried a whole number of alternatives. Track number one is not jumping. My guess would be it's something to do with this connection in the UCD or something like that. We try to jump using regular gearing pads. Smelly. I hate to grab it and stick around for it.
I'm on 61, but...
Yeah.
What state vector is in the left slot, the left?
Because I never drove 66, I don't think that's the last vector is good.
Yeah, we'll probably ought to.
Flap. Maybe. Post TPI.
Yeah, the movie is looking like that.
Buy a new home for it, because that old home is full of a smelly old urine bag. The floodlight isn't made the bottom of the package for him, yes,
ma'am.
I
don't know what that is. You're
going to have to put the fairy.
There's not a beer in there.
Oh, God, why is it?
What? Yeah, stop.
visitors tonight. I don't yearn for visitors right now. I yearn for a nice dip. Probably, yeah. I heard them this morning when I woke up, but probably there's a hydrogen as well.
No, I think so too. What, 47? 33, 47?
look like a wild gyration.
Hello.
Well, the Vic's been doing pretty good numbers. If I'd known how it was going to develop, I wouldn't have gone right at the bottom when they did. But I've been in the habit of, as soon as contact was made, I looked at it. Looks okay, I'll fly at the bottom right away. So I figured, oh, yeah, you know, it's going to develop. No,
I fired that guy in a bottle. Wow. Yeah, it's pretty close right here. The other one is just good. It's kind of good.
The other one
is not so good.
Pretty good, considering nobody knew where we were.
data can go to a lot, too. The only good thing to say about it is it's six countries in England here to think of people.
Thank you. Mark what?
This is Apollo Control at 133 hours, 45 minutes. We're now 50 seconds from reacquiring Apollo 11 on the 30th revolution of the moon. This will be our last front side pass before trans-Earth injection. On this revolution, we'll be passing up to the crew the final computations for their trans-Earth injection maneuver, which is scheduled to occur at 135 hours, 23 minutes, 42 seconds, or about 1 hour, 38 minutes from now.
Parade across the main.
We should have acquisition of signal now in about 10 seconds. We'll stand by.
Look at that.
We've acquired the signal from the spacecraft. We're standing by at this time for a call from the crew, or for Capcom Charlie Duke to put in a call to the crew from the ground. We presently show the lunar module in an orbit 63.3 by 56 nautical miles. The command and service module is in an orbit 63.2 by 53.9. At the time of the trans-Earth injection burn, we expect that the command module will be about 1 mile below the LEM and about 20 miles in front of it.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston, we're standing by. All right, so we'd like you sometime at your convenience to stir up the cryos on this pass. And I'm wondering if you got the fuel cell purge, over. Say again, you're breaking up.
Roger, the O2 fuel cell purge is complete.
Roger, copy. Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. We got a load for you if you give us poo and accept. The load consists of a CSM pre-TEI state vector. It's going in the CSM slots and a post-TEI state vector. It'll go into the LEM slots, if that's okay. And also a TEI target load. Any comments, over?
Very good. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
Poo and accept. You got it.
Thank you. And 11 Houston, a reminder, you can scratch the verb 66 at
13430.
And 11 Houston, for your information, Eagle, we had an ISS fail light came on at about 3:19 due to an CDU overheating, and at about this time at AOS, it looks like we're about to lose the platform.
This is Apollo Control. At this time, the crew should be involved in their pre-trans-earth injection status checks. And they'll also be aligning the platform on their spacecraft guidance system. And we'll be passing up the final information for the trans-earth injection burn computed on the ground. A few minutes ago, you heard Charlie Duke advise the crew that we show the LEM platform is about to go. We'd mentioned that prior to leaving the lunar module, the crew had deactivated the primary coolant loop, placing the secondary coolant loop in operation aboard the LEM. This means that the primary guidance system does not get cooling. This is part of a pre-planned test to find out just how long the primary guidance system would continue to function without cooling. We had predicted in advance that it would possibly not last much longer than an hour or so. But at the time Charlie Duke reported the platform had just gone down on the LEM, it had been in operation without cooling a little more than 4 hours. And we had an approximate time from the crew of transferring to the secondary coolant loop of about 129 hours, 40 minutes. And we got the report from Duke that the LEM guidance platform was no longer usable at 133 hours, 55 minutes. We'll continue to stand by for any further conversation from the crew. We're now 1 hour, 24 minutes, 10 seconds away from trans-earth injection, which will occur on the backside of the moon at the beginning of the 31st revolution.
Apollo 11, Houston, we got the load in. You can have the computer.
Apollo 11, you threw the computer?
That's affirmative, Buzz.
Right. That's timing for you.
Apollo 11 Houston, your friendly white team has your coming home information if you're ready to copy, over. Roger 11, got two pads for you, TEI 30 and then a TEI 31. TEI 30, SPS, GNN, 36, 69 or 1, minus 061, plus 066, 135, 234156 981 32 correction plus 32011 plus 06818 minus 02650 181 054 014. Apogee is NA. Perigee plus 00230. 3286. Correction. 32836. Burn time 228. 32628. 24. 1511357. Next three lines are NA. Noun 61 plus 1103 minus 17237 11806 36275 1950452. Set stars are Deneb and Vega, 242-172-012. We'd like ullage of two jets for 16 seconds. And the horizon is on the 10-degree line at TIG minus 2 minutes. And your sextant star is visible after 134 plus 50. Stand by on your readback. I have a TEI 31 if you're ready to copy, over.
Roger, TEI 30. SBS GNN. 36691. Minus 061. Plus 066-135-23-4156 plus 32011 plus 06818 minus 02650 181-054-014 FCNA plus 00230
Buzz, good read back. You're very weak. If you're ready to copy, I got a TEI 31 for you, over.
Alright, go ahead.
Apollo 11, Houston, you were cut out. Say again. TEI 31, SPS GNN, 36691, minus 061, plus 066, 137, 22, 39er, 85, plus 32838. Plus 06845 minus 02487 NA pitch 052. Rest of the pad is NA. Ready for your read back, over.
Roger, TEI 31. SPS GNN 36691 minus 061 plus 066 137 22 39 85 plus 32838 plus 7. NA, it's 052. The rest is NA. Over.
Roger, good read back. And Buzz, did you say sextant star visible after 13450?
No, I wrote down 13410. I wasn't real sure about that.
Roger, it went by me there. Retro caught it. It's 13450. Over.
Okay, 13450. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
This is Apollo Control at 134 hours, 10 minutes. We have about 47 minutes, 30 seconds before losing contact with Apollo 11 as it goes behind the moon in preparation for the trans-Earth injection burn. With the burn, we would reacquire the spacecraft at 135 hours, 34 minutes, 11 seconds. Without the trans-Earth injection burn on the upcoming revolution, we would reacquire at 135 hours, 43 minutes, 50 seconds. The final figures on that burn, as passed up to the crew a few minutes ago, are as follows. Ignition will occur at 135 hours, 23 minutes, 42 seconds. The burn duration will be 2 minutes, 28 seconds. That will add 3,284 feet per second to the spacecraft velocity, starting it on its path back to Earth. And we would consume about 10,000 pounds of propellant with that burn. Splash would occur, according to our preliminary figures, just about precisely as predicted in the flight plan. We'll continue to monitor now for any further conversation from the spacecraft.
Thank you.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. After the burn, we'd like you to trim X and Z. Over.
Okay, John.
Roger, and that's to 2/10 of a foot per second as shown in the flight plan.
Sounds like there's a story behind that one, too.
We'll tell you when you get back. Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. Would you verify that you've stirred up the crowds? Over.
Roger, we stirred them up.
Thank you, sir.
This is Apollo Control at 134 hours, 32 minutes. Flight Director Gene Kranz just requested his flight controllers to review all of their data, take a good look at the spacecraft, and be prepared to make go, no-go recommendations shortly for the trans-Earth injection burn. That maneuver now 51 minutes, 27 seconds away. All systems on the spacecraft looking good at this point. The cabin temperature has been running about 72 degrees. At this time, the crew is aligning the platform on their guidance system, the stable platform used as an attitude reference for the upcoming burn. We've had very little conversation, both here in the control center and from the spacecraft on this pass. We'll continue to stand by and monitor.
Apollo 11, Houston, you're a go for TEI, over.
Apollo 11, thank you.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 134 hours, 48 minutes. It continues very quiet here in Mission Control. The flight controllers have been observing the crew inputs to their computer, monitoring as the crew prepares for the trans-earth injection burn, scheduled to occur at about 35 minutes from now. We have now 9 minutes 20 seconds until loss of signal. The spacecraft currently traveling at a speed of 5,329 feet per second, and the altitude is 62.5 nautical miles. At the time of the trans-earth injection burn, the lunar module, Eagle, should be about 20 miles behind the command module.
Apollo 11 Houston, you got about 8 minutes till LOS. Your AOS with the burn, 135-3405. No burn, 135-44. Over.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir.
The crew has a go for the trans-earth injection at the beginning of the 31st revolution, and all systems on the spacecraft are looking very good at this point. You heard Capcom Charlie Duke advise Mike Collins that we'll reacquire the spacecraft on the other side of the moon with the burn at a ground elapsed time of 135 hours, 34 minutes, and 5 seconds. Without the burn, we would reacquire at 135 hours, 44 minutes, 3 seconds. We now have 6 minutes, 50 seconds until loss of signal. We'll continue to monitor.
Apollo 11 Houston, 1 minute to LOS, go Sikkim.
Thank you, sir, we'll do it.
Seconds now until loss of signal. We've had a last status check from the flight director, and all around the room the word is go. We're now 26 minutes 23 seconds from the transverse injection maneuver. 20 minutes until loss of signal.
Okay, I'm ready to proceed now.
Do it.
Here we go. Got to make a start check yet.
And we have lost a signal now. We should next reacquire Apollo 11 at 135 hours, 34 minutes, 5 seconds.
I'll take care of it.
We might run it post.
And we're now 25 minutes, 38 seconds from transverse injection.
Going away from the minute. I just get wire in the way. Get on. Well, yeah, pull it out of the way. I have it right here.
Got down here half a row.
How about your wildlife? No, I don't care about it. Well, if it's annoying, let me, I can get it if it is. Yeah,
I'll get it. Start checking for the stress.